Hi, I'm Lisa.
And I'm Jonathan.
And we're Creative for Learning.
Today, we're going to talk about class novel studies and how to hook student learners from the get-go.
Maybe you've been there before. You're about to start a six-week study through a novel, and you're looking for a way to get them into it, to get them, you know, emotionally engaged with what you're, the novel you're going to spend 6 weeks on, or however many weeks, to get them not to be bored. So we want to give you a quick practical tip to get things started off right.
Patrick Lencioni's book, Death by Meeting, go check it out. And you can see our longer video here about conflict and stuff, talks about the most interesting thing to us humans. And yes, students are humans too. The most interesting thing to us is conflict. We love it. We do. It seems maybe seems contradictory, counterintuitive, but we love to disagree and to fight and to discuss and joust and all of that. We love when things shock us. So when thinking about how to start your novel off, think, how can I engage them in some healthy conflict to start?
Another super important way to engage them is to activate prior knowledge and opinions. People love sharing their opinions and what they already know, and they love feeling like they're in on the conversation and can contribute.
And since we'll be studying the novel for a while, wouldn't it be great if we could foreshadow the important themes and events and topics and plant seeds in their mind so when they see them later, they go, subconsciously or consciously?
We start all of the novel units off the same way, and we want to teach you how. One method does all of these: instigating healthy conflict, engaging prior knowledge and opinions, and foreshadowing compelling themes that will come up in the story.
So the way we do it is we think through all of the major themes and events in this story. Then we craft 9 statements. You can pick however many you want, but we found 9 is pretty good, that assert something to be true. Here's some samples. It is okay to lie to people. That's one from our giver unit.
People are the result of their choices, not the environment they grew up. That's from The Outsiders.
And from To Kill a Mockingbird, some kinds of people are trash compared to others.
And from The Great Gatsby, everyone should have to work just as hard, no matter how rich they are.
So you see, some of these are controversial. They may even be like shocking, or they may just seem obvious. But to other kids, they're not obvious, right? Because the purpose here is to make them choose a side. There's no maybes here. They have to pick.
This gets really fun when you get the learners up and moving around the room. First, have them make their 9 choices on their own, and then have them stand up and move physically to different sides of the room, depending on their opinion for each question. So if you agree, go over here, and if you disagree, over here. Jonathan likes to use PowerPoint for each prompt, so it's up on the, so it's projected up so that they can analyze every word and they can specifically point out which word they disagree on.
Yeah, it really gets into some deep kind of logic and philosophy, because they'll start arguing over one word. And I'm like, yes, I got them in the logic battle here. And then they'll find, like, I let them switch sides too. If they realize, oh, that word changes it, I go, all right, you want to switch, don't you? And then they switch over to the other side. And it's super fun.
So there's lots of critical thinking.
Yeah, it's so engaging. I love this activity because they all have opinions. And in this fun action format, they all really love sharing their ideas. It's crazy how many of them actually out loud share their ideas. And as the teacher, you'll need to moderate the environment, so it's all about respect, but encourage their honest opinions. I'm always amazed at how much my middle school students think through these issues. And then I get to be the one in the middle that like asks follow-up questions sometimes to both sides so that I'm not playing favorites. I never even tell them my opinion on the topic.
That's what I was just gonna ask. So you say stay neutral.
I stay neutral, but I'll ask challenging questions to both sides.
To both sides.
Yeah.
So they know that you're not favoring either one. And this allows for an organized argument. So let people from each side share their thoughts, then ask for people who disagree, and the more conflict, the better.
Yeah, this usually takes a solid 45-minute class period for my students, and they're still discussing things on the way out of class.
Which is awesome.
Absolutely.
As you work through the story, these topics will come up, and you can reference the discussion from this day. So remember back when we did our pre-reading bias?
Then after you finish reading the novel, you'll revisit these topics. You can even pull out the brainstorm page again, have them keep it, and then they'll see how their opinions have changed. They will be surprised, and you will probably will too, at how the story has influenced and informed their beliefs. It's pretty powerful.
I realize I said the pre-reading bias, but do you call it that to your students?
That's I just, do.
You do?
Well, it says it on the paper, online, yeah.
So a quick recap. To hook the students into a novel, stir up conflict, engage their prior knowledge, and foreshadow the big themes that will come up. Any activity you do that does all three of these is bound to hook them from the start.
Yep. So our conversation for the day, what activities do you love doing to hook students at the start of the novel study?
Share
those down in the bottom, and then maybe do a little quick analysis and see, does it do all of those three? Right? And that might show how powerful they are. So thanks for being here and keep being awesome.